Moses fell into disfavor with the Pharaoh for having killed an Egyptian guard who unjustly beat an old Hebrew slave. And as he felt his life was in danger, he fled to the desert. Riding a camel, he traveled for many days under the burning sun. He became unrecognizable. When he came to a well, he lifted the stone that covered it and refreshed himself with its water and filled his flask. Moses set eyes on a cave near the well and decided it would be his shelter for the night. After he lit a fire, he quietly fell asleep. A drop of water falling on his face woke him up. He drank, and then he looked around to discover that somebody had stolen his camel during the night. Distressed by his loss, he called out in vain before deciding to continue his journey on foot. He walked under the sun across the arid desert, following camel tracks, hoping to find his camel. Unfortunately, Moses' hopes faded away when he saw a caravan of camels, and his was not among them. Disappointed and discouraged, Moses continued his journey across the desert. He was very tired, and worse still, had no more water to drink. He let himself collapse on the sand, feeling sure that this was his hour of death. But his will to survive won, and with his strength of mind, Moses resumed walking his lonely trek through the desert. All of a sudden, he saw a valley, in the center of which there was a tent and four camels. Three men were camping outside the tent. Moses watched them for a long time, and after drinking some water, he decided to attack them.
What should we do?
Run! Run! Get out of here!
What do we do?
Just get out of here!
Get out of here!
Run! Come on, run! Run! Run!
Run!
Moses resumed his journey under the burning sun on one camel, towing the other three camels. But any man that ventures into the hot desert takes his life in his hands. After this dangerous adventure, Moses continued his journey. He arrived at the sea, and he walked along the shore. Finally, he left the sea behind and reached a wonderful place. A large, green, fertile oasis with tall trees, luxurious plants, and a well full of water. Moses was tired, and he lay down under a tree to rest.
Luke, have you ever seen him?
No. But he's very handsome.
He must be a warrior.
He's sleeping just like a little baby.
Come on. Oh, look, here they are. Oh no, here they come.
The daughters of Jethro.
They're stealing our water. Get out of it, this water's ours. Get out. Just missed it, didn't you?
Get back to your father immediately.
Help us, please! Help!
Please,
they're killing us!
Oh, please, someone! Please. Do you really think we don't know how to defend ourselves?
Get off me!
Look out! That man is armed!
Well, let's get out of here then, come on!
You villains, leave these girls in peace! And never show yourselves again.
Oh, thank you, they've gone.
I'll never come back, you horrible men.
Oh, thank you so.
Why did you come back? I ordered you to collect water. Did you bring it?
While we took it, the shepherds came. They'll kill us if we go back to draw water of that well, and they'll kill you too, Father. A warrior saved us.
A warrior?
Yes, he had a flaxen suit covered with gold. He was tall, he had wavy hair and a tapered beard.
He's an Egyptian, daughters, as the prophecy foretold.
The Egyptian warrior from the prophecy?
But why didn't you bring him here?
We were frightened.
But if he defended you, we must repay him, my daughters.
Yes, the warrior defended us.
Then go and find him, my daughters, and bring him here so that I can thank him.
But Father, right
now... Yes, bring him here. He might be hungry. And you two should prepare some food for him. He will need to eat. You defended my daughters. Who are you? Where do you come from?
I'm an Egyptian soldier.
What's your name, my friend?
My name is Moses.
Your name means saved from the water. Are you a Jew?
Yes, I am a Jew. But don't ask me who I am.
Who is your father?
I don't even know who my father is.
Why are you here, Moses?
To find out.
You'll find out. Please.
This is delicious kid meat.
The girls are very grateful you rescued them and have prepared this food for you. Tell me, Egyptian, who is the pharaoh that reigns in Egypt now?
The pharaoh that reigns in Egypt now is the great, powerful Ramses II.
But his ancestor was only an archer.
Yes, but he made his kingdom grow big and strong. Ah, this staff is engraved with holy names. Abraham, Isaac, Israel.
They are the patriarchs of the people of God, the one and only God. Now take the oil lamp, my friend, and sleep.
Thank you, but I really do not want to disturb you.
You're not disturbing me. I want to thank you for helping my daughters.
I would have done it for anyone, sir.
Regardless, I'm very grateful for what you did, brave knight.
You'll see you'll be fine with us, Moses.
I know that. Look, it's Ashtar's. The brightest of all stars.
Men's eyes are like stars too. Some shine brightly, others seem quite dull.
Be careful, it's hot. Excuse me. Tell me, priest, how many days do we still have to walk to reach Babylonia?
20 days at least. Where are you coming from?
From the lands of the pharaoh, the richest in the world.
Ramses the pharaoh? Did you see him?
I don't want to see him. They say he's so resplendent, whoever sees him goes blind.
No, that's not true. I saw him many times.
You saw him many times? And why?
What are you doing?
I'm putting my treasury in order, everything I own. I'm selling it in Babylon. I hope to earn twice as much.
How much for one of those?
The sheep.
Fine.
Nah.
Why did you come here?
To see my dear husband. I was waiting for you.
Why is the thorn bush not burning?
Moses! Moses!
Here I am!
Don't get closer. Take off your sandals, because the place you're standing on is holy ground. I am the God of thy father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob. I have seen the affliction of my people in Egypt, and I have heard their cry on account of their taskmasters, and I know their sorrows. I want to free them and bring them out into a beautiful and spacious land, a land flowing with milk and honey. Therefore I send you to the Pharaoh. Go to him and bring out of Egypt the children of Israel, my people.
But Lord, who am I to go to the Pharaoh? Who am I to command him to bring the children of Israel out of Egypt?
I'm with you, Moses, and this is a sign for you to prove that I sent you, and when you have brought my people out of Egypt, you will worship me on this mountain, Mount Horeb.
My lord, I will go to the children of Israel, but if they ask me who sends me, what shall I say?
I am that I am. This is my name.
You are my lord, and I will obey, but when I'm in front of the children of Israel, and I tell them what you told me to say, I am that I am, my lord.
Say to the elders of Israel, I will lead you out of Egypt. Take them to the king of Egypt and tell him, the God of the Hebrews appeared to us. Let us go into the wilderness to offer a sacrifice to our God, but the king of Egypt won't let you go. Then I will stretch out my hand and I will smite Egypt with 7 plagues never seen before. Only then will he let you go.
My lord, will the elders of Israel believe me? No, they won't believe me, because they will say, no, the Lord did not appear to you. You're a liar. You're lying, and we do not believe you. I beg you, my lord, do not send me to the elders, as they will not listen.
I am your God, the God of your father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, and you doubt my word?
No, Lord my God. Until I live, I will never doubt your word.
What do you have in your hand, Moses?
A staff.
Throw it! Stop, Moses! Stretch out your hand and pick it up by the tail. You will perform this sign so that they would believe that the Lord, the God of their fathers, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, appeared to you. Put your hand in your bosom. Put your hand in your bosom again. If they don't believe and they don't listen to the first sign, they will believe the second one. If they don't believe these 2 signs at all and don't listen to your voice, then you will take some water from the river. You'll pour it on the dry land and it will turn into blood.
I am not eloquent, my lord. I wasn't in the past, and I haven't become it since you spoke to your servant. I'm slow with words and tongue.
Who gave man a mouth, or who maketh dumb or deaf or seeing or blind? Am I not me, the Lord? Then go, I will talk through your mouth, and I will teach you what to say. The one who'll speak for you will be a prophet, your brother, the prophet Aaron, the Levite.
My brother, my Lord? You say I have a brother?
You have a brother, Moses, a Levite, who is a good speaker and who is now coming to meet you. When you see him, he will give you courage in your heart. You will speak to him, and you will put your words into his mouth. I shall be with you when you speak. I shall be your mouth, and I shall teach you what you must do. He will speak for you to the people. When he speaks, you will hold in your hand the staff with which you will perform miracles.
I am your servant, Lord. When I come back, he will be grown up.
I'm worried about you.
Now, go to Egypt, to your brothers, Moses, and don't look back. Obey the Lord! So Moses left to return to the land of Egypt, leaving his son and wife, but carrying the staff that God had given him to demonstrate to the Pharaoh the wonders that God had told him to perform.
Aaron! Aaron!
My lord, tell me what I have to do.
Go meet Moses in the wilderness.
Moses, who was safe in the waters, my lord?
Yes, Moses, your brother.
Where is my brother now, my lord?
Near the mountain of God.
Then you must mean Mount Horeb, my lord.
And so Aaron set off toward Mount Horeb to meet his brother.
You are Moses, safe from the waters.
You are Aaron, my brother.
The Lord told me I would find you on Mount Horeb.
I knew that I would meet you.
Moses and Aaron together went and gathered the elders of Israel.
I announce to you the will of God. We will all depart from this land and head for the land of Canaan, the land promised to our fathers by Jehovah, blessed be his name.
Where were you when we were suffering? You were in the palace of the Pharaoh, leading the life of a prince. Now you say to leave Egypt. Do you think it's easy? Will you tell the Pharaoh not to set his guards against us? I think you're lying. I think you only want to lead our people so you can make your own terms with the Pharaoh and maybe receive favors from him. Is that not true? Am I not right?
Wait, Simeon. You've known me ever since I was born. Why do you talk this way to Moses?
Because I'm afraid of what the Pharaoh will do against us when he hears what you have to say to him, huh?
And how can we be sure that Jehovah spoke to this man?
It's the Almighty who sent me to meet him in the wilderness at the foot of the Holy Mountain. And it's the Almighty who put his power in his hands, so that through his mouth, Jehovah speaks.
Aaron, so which power do you mean?
God should never show his power.
Did you see?
Only Jehovah is capable of doing that.
Perhaps you're nothing more than a magician.
You are only a mere magician. Oh, you have leprosy sores.
This can only be the Lord's work.
The people trusted them. They bowed and worshipped the God of Abraham, of Isaac, and of Jacob. They understood that his heart had visited the sons of Israel and had seen their affliction. Moses and his brother Aaron had accomplished the first part of the work that the Lord had commanded them.
I am that I am, this is my name.